morning, everybody. Welcome to the anniversary edition of Mother Talks. We welcome Mr. V Sridhar to coming down to our campus. He will start the video. From Hyderabad comes the National Creative Director of Leo Burnett, Mr. K.V. Sridhar. Mr. Sridhar is a BSc graduate from Tasmania University and a Fine Arts graduate from Gulbarga. He started his career with feature films. His first as an art director was Kukka in 1978. In the year 2000, Leo Burnett India has been chosen as a global agency of the year, top among the Leo Burnett Network's 94 offices in 86 countries. K.V. Sridhar is the only Indian jury member to be a part of the list of judges at the New York Festivals 2009. Mr. Sridhar will play an integral role in judging the television and cinema advertising category. At Lloyd, where he was a creative consultant, he worked on the Khattam commercial for Pepsodent with Balki, and ads for St. Gobain, Parker Pens, LG Television and Air Conditioners, and Bajaj Puri Baba. Mr. Sridhar created the Complan Forte campaign, a print ad for Coca-Cola, Thums Up, and HDFC Standard Life ads and campaigns for Sonora and Bajaj Bikes. In 2008, he mentored several successful ads, which included a Thums Up film with Akshay Kumar performing high-speed racing stunts in narrow alleys of Malaysia. Where is the Pub for Minute Maid and Shake Maid for McDonald's also made a mark. Last year, Leo Burnett India won 6 Lions at Cannes, including 2 Gold Lions, Fringe and Outdoor Grand Prix at India's World Fest, and multiple awards at all major award shows, including One Show, D&D, and Clio. Mr. Sridhar is credited with the emergence of Leo Burnett as a creative powerhouse in India. Creativity Magazine ranks Leo Burnett India among top 20 creative agencies in the world. We welcome you, sir, for coming down to our campus. I would request Pooja to present to the
Now I look like an option. Okay. Advertising, guys. It's all hype. Finally. Advertising is so simple, so pleasurable. You have to do nothing. Today, I have got a paid holiday. I'm wearing a shirt like this. Okay, from Bombay to Goa. And then spending a day with you guys. And then going back. And then telling my kids that I have spent a day with kids. And all this comes for nothing. Virtually nothing. In the morning, because I spent a couple of hours with a couple of guys and girls. They were asking lots of curious questions. What I just want to answer them before I start out. What qualifications are needed to be in advertising? Nothing. Enjoy life. Live life well. Okay. Because the job which we do has two simple parts. One, read Economic Times every day. Know what is happening in the industry. What is happening to, use a terminology, the new terminology which everybody uses today, is the new ecosystem in which brands, businesses operate. And then the second part is draw from the emotional bank which you have got. You put lots of observations and experiences of your life before you turn 15, and then you forget about them. When you become 25 and when you become successful in advertising, you start drawing from the bank of observations and experiences you have or you had in earlier part of your life. Up to the age of 15, we are very innocent, simple human beings. We have no selfish motives or interests. We don't make a friend because he's going to give you business. We don't make a friend because when she grows up, she's going to be busy with us. Correct? So we have absolutely nothing in life which binds us or allows us to see in a certain way. We experience everything without any reason, without any selfish motive. When you go back, now, look back, and then you remember those things and collect those and use them. Which is not a rocket science, but my grandmother used to sit at home and used to narrate all the experiences, what did Mahatma Gandhi did, what did somebody else did, and she never got paid for using her memories. Today I get paid for using my memories and experiences. And to be successful in advertising, there are two things. One, be a great human being and love life and live life well, observe everything and then use those experiences whenever they are required. Creativity is nothing but connecting two unconnected things together. If my grandfather never took help and he cooked his own food in the middle of jungles, has nothing to do with insurance sector today. Correct? But what is common between an insurance and the way my grandfather behaved when he was working under British, was self-respect. He never allowed anybody to help him. The same thing today, which is used for a brand who is making lots of money for it. For that, I get paid, get called to go up. Stupid, no? That is the only qualification you need. Only qualification you need is to live life well and ability to use things from life. And other thing which you need is, it is quite stupid and I feel very awkward to introduce myself as a grade 2 guy. Somebody introduces you as a grade 2 guy. Everybody is grade 2. Who is not grade 2? Tell me any one of you who has not painted when you were a kid. Tell me any one of you who has not recited a poem when you were a kid. Tell me anyone who has not played cricket when you were a kid or any sport when you were a kid. We all do everything. We are all born equal. It is that some children have the ability and interest to continue painting, they will become musicians. Some children will continue to sing, they will become either Lata Mangeshkar or Anu Malik.
Not Buffy Lions.
Some children have the ability of playing cricket or any other sport, and then they will go on to become sports people. And what makes advertising people that if you don't grow up and then be a child all your life, then you are a good advertising person. Because what you need is childlike simplicity when you take complex problems and then find the simplistic solutions. For that you need a mindset of a six-year-old. If you don't have a six-year-old mindset, you cannot simplify. You know, how can such complex things which run into risk of several crores, you just say that you know, it's a simple issue. Correct. So that ability of being remain all your life as a kid is what gets you to advertising. And enthusiasm. You show a child an ice cream, they will jump up and down. You show Facebook to a grown-up guy like me, I will jump up and down. Because that's the only way I can be connected with my daughter. Gone are the days, I was telling somebody that in the car, that gone are the days where we sit around a dining table, entire family, and say our prayers, and at the same time, talk about what happened during the day in everybody's life. Now I don't meet my children. I have to go onto the Facebook to know what happened to that whole day, what is the state of mind, what happened, and then share the pictures. When I am not there, what happened at home, she will put pictures on the Facebook. I will know, world will know before I know what happened to my own house. And that is what is needed, not just as a father I need to be connected with my family, as an old guy I need to be connected with young guys like you. But brands are the same. They need to be connected with the audiences. If they don't get connected with the audiences, like I become outdated, then I have to take my name Pops very seriously and then retire or go to Haridwar. Brands will become the same. The Hamara Bajaj, you know, the old Bajaj scooter company was rejected by everyone because it has not progressed. It has become old. It has become black for this company. Then Raju Bajaj took over. And he did not try to sell the same scooter, which everybody thinks that is their father's and grandfather's brand. We made motorcycles for the younger generations to be relevant. And Bajaj was back. The brand Bajaj was back because it was relevant to the new target audiences. Where Rahul Bajaj, I know this company last 15 years I've been working on their brands. Rahul Bajaj never, you know, he is one of those man with lots of values. He never believed that he should make motorcycles. He hated motorcycles because more accidents happen with motorcycles. People speed up. It's not good for young people to actually speed up. So he took the next generation family to actually come and then say that I want to make a motorcycle, not a sorry motorcycle, but a fantastic motorcycle, which world will applaud. And they had to reinvent themselves. Entire company has reinvented themselves. Their R&D reinvented, their auto reinvented themselves, everything. And then they made this magical product called Pulsar, which is very simple technology called DTSI. And DTSI is nothing, it's a twin spark plug. You know, instead of one spark plug, they put in the engine the second spark plug, so that more combustion happens, therefore more power. More combustion happens, therefore more money. Such a simple thing. Correct? He's creative. He's extremely creative. The R&D guy who invented DTSI technology, his name is Joe. And Joe is extremely creative. And then what he has done is like a child. Okay, simple solution. Now today, some 20,000 crores is riding on that solution. That twin ignition. Correct? That ability of being a child all your life and then breaking down complex problems. The simple solution is what creativity is all about. And people get paid lots of money for that. So guys, without doing anything, want to be simple, come to advertising. Coming to brands, you know, that's what the institute asked me to talk about. And the progress which the world has made. They're talking about finding relevant place, be it human beings in our society or brands in the society. So how do we reinvent ourselves to be contemporary all the time? It's not very easy. You need effort. You need effort. Like, I had to put in effort to understand what Second Life is, create my own avatar, and then interact with people whom I don't know. I don't know whether they are men, women, or somewhere in between, what age group, which color, which country, nothing. Once you make an effort, then you learn something. And then when you learn something, then you create some interest and you can be meaningful to them. A lot of brands in the world today, if they are not relevant, they are out. Because new consumers are coming. It's very nice to say that India has a population of over 55%, which is under 25. What will happen to almost 67% of the population, which is under 20? Within 3 to 5 years, they are going to become your consumers. They will have more purchasing power than anybody else. And how are you going to scale? Not just to this 25-year-old guy today, but 5 years from now, this 19-year-old guy who's coming, whose life is completely different, who's living in a very different world, their mindset is different, they live in a boundaryless world. Completely, the social networking is having a huge, huge impact on everyone. They can share things with people, they can actually live in a very different world. And today, you know, family is whose family? Father, mother, brother is not family. And the people who are there on your networking are your family. You want to share every moment with them, every picture with them, every thought with them. They might be in 10 different countries. So how do you deal with new families? What do they consume? What do they do? And how do you actually belong to them? And that is what every brand is trying to do. And that is what brands need to do also to remain contemporary, otherwise they are out. Have you seen the old brands, Western TV, Lambretta, Ambassador Car, lots of other things they've gone. Yeah. Whoever has contemporized themselves became a meaningful guy. They knew. Otherwise, everybody has gone. What happened to all the actors who were there along with Amitabh Bachchan? Where have they gone? They're all living, they're not dead. Why Dharmendra is not making so many movies, not endorsing brands? Why Vinod Khanna is not endorsing brands? Only Sanjeev Kumar is gone. Rest of the guys are still hanging around. But what happened to them? Why only Bachchan? He's still making money, still people talk about him, still he is very active, still he is alive as a brand. Because he made himself meaningful to the target audience. Some 8 years back, you know, when I was interacting with Bachchan for Parker, the first time we were talking, you know, the kind of ad which he wanted to make. Then he said, why don't you use me as an actor? I said, you are not an actor. No. You think that you are an actor. I am selling pens to a 15-year-old, 16-year-old. They have not seen. Each time they see you, they will say, daddy, black and white, you see. How? You are only relevant in their life with KBC. That revived you. They only knew you as an actor who pulls everybody's legs. And you crack jokes with everyone. And that's the only relevance you have. People don't know your Zanjeev, people don't know your Anand, people don't know your movies. The target audience which you were talking to, they only knew as the KBC uncle. So, we did an ad where actually he teases people. And it became a very big hit because he understood the value of connecting with the target audience. And everything in his life he did was to do that all the time. And if Amitabh Bachchan can do that, an actor who has no training in brand management, marketing, there is no conference room, there are not hundreds of guys with ties and PowerPoint sitting and debating, if he could do that, why can't marketers do? Okay, so the first part of my presentation is going to be how do you actually build brands and how do you keep them relevant in very traditional way, in normal way. The second part, which is television, television is the biggest medium through which you speak to your audiences. And the second part of the presentation is going to be today. today how brands are built to people like you, who are not sitting in front of a television. Can you tell me how many of you have opened a computer yesterday? How many of you have seen a television set yesterday? See, only both of us are there. How do you expect, you know, though in India the reality is going to be next 5 to 6 years, television is going to be very big, but rest of the world it is not. People are not looking at it. Even if they watch television overnight, they are not watching it live. They record it and then watch whenever they have time. So the second part is technology and also lifestyle. Both have changed. Mindsets have changed. Brands are changing their mindsets. I'm going to show you some new work which is happening across the world and how people are using the new technologies and new mediums which are coming in to connect with data technologies. Okay. When we talk about brands, now what is the difference between a brand and a product? Anybody wants to take that?
You are not that kind of a guy.
but mentally you want to feel like that. You see a Jackie Chan film and then you come out and then your hands into moving without any rhyme or reason, because you have got used to it. In your mind you think that you are Jackie Chan, because we tend to believe that what we see we can do it. That's the secret of Kon Banega Karodpati. The first 15 questions, you know, 10 questions are so deceptive, and will say that I can do it with my left hand. Who does not know Kuti Aramani songs? Who does not know Mizar Grammar School of the same? Correct? So that deceives you. That, yeah, if you wait, and in the same way, when you actually see things, it makes you feel that, yeah, you can be like that. You can become like that in your own mind, not physically. So that gratification of what you are not, you seek refuge in different circles. And why people go ahead and spend all their life's money and then buy a Mercedes? Because it's the most well-inflated machine in the world. And if you wait to have an accident, head-on collision with anything, nothing will happen to you, entire car will collapse. Because it has been designed such a way. But people buy for that reason? They want the bag value. I am CEO, I have got a Mercedes. And still, what do? When they go back home, even if it is Anil Ambani who bought his S-class Mercedes for 1.2 crores, he has to go ahead and tell his wife and justify it. No, I have bought it because I will be safe. And wife will take out Mangal Sutra and do this, okay, my husband will be safe. Indulge yourself. Because rational reasons and emotional reasons are the two reasons. Rational reasons is what to tell people you are buying it for. Emotional reasons are the reasons why you actually buy it. Not how many people in a blind test would know the difference between Pepsi and Thumbs Up? Very few. You are not buying because, you know, I am from Andhra, I like spicy things. I like to drink Thumbs Up meat with chicken. That's what Andhra guys say. But you are not buying for all those reasons. You are buying because of the macro image. You want to go out and climb walls and then, you know, bash 10 other guys. So that is the core essence, you know. Emotionally, there is rationally, there is a brand truth or the product truth, and there is a human truth. You put both of them together, you get a brand. So what do you do? You got a brand. You got a batch of people across the world. You need to channel that. You need to actually say, and then Thumbs Up used to be a brand which used to bash up people and get the girl. In 70s and 80s, if you see the advertising of Thumbs Up, okay, the guy used to go and then bash up and then steal other guys' girlfriends also and then go. And people used to applaud and say that, ah, what a great hero he is. I am doing that today. You know, the guy who's been bashed in the 90s when we relaunched Thumbs Up, the research showed that the guy who's been bashed used to get all the girls' sympathy. Not the body guy who has got muscles and then work and then bash. Suddenly we said, you know, that guy is the hero, not this guy. The guy who's been getting bashed. So we relaunched Thumbs Up in around 1993-94. I don't know whether you guys have seen, remember somewhere, some archives. Maybe you are little kids trying to do the same stunt that a guy who does bungee jumping and then gets the bottom.
Yes.
The first time, you know, he does bungee jumping not because he wants to impress a girl, because he wants to drink and he does not even want people to acknowledge that he has done such an incredible stunt. Because the research showed that time people have changed. In our days, you know, we have to tear our trousers, you know, ruffle our hair, grow our beard, have a jolly. If somebody, your parents say that, you know, you are looking good, then you tear your shirts a little more, but you don't want to look good to them. We used to be little rebellious, you know, we want to do things which are slightly different. And we don't want permission and we don't want acknowledgement from establishment. So that's how we grew, Naxalite guys.
Okay.
Now in 90s, if you ask children, they want their mothers to approve how do they look, tone body, stop smoking, running, Nike shoes, iron jeans, little more respectful towards women. So suddenly, if that has changed, if the brand has not changed, and then you want to go ahead and mash up 100 guys and steal every girlfriend, how can you be wonderful? How can you find a place in those guys again? Right, then the bank started slightly going down, and we launched this campaign. And ever since that, including Salman Khan, never bashed it. He only said this is better color than that. So that is very important. And the second part, couple of days back, you will see something different. we are living in PlayStation era. That's the only clue I can give, and then see the next commercial. And you cannot change, you know, you cannot change because the character of the brand is natural. And then you have to redefine what that naturalness is. Doing for himself, being a little more cool, screaming back at her, having fun. But you cannot change the character of very macho, action, accelerating kind of experience when you actually drink or see Thumbs Up ads. That is how, year on year, brick by brick, which nobody can take away from you. And people, it's always like, you know, that you like somebody and then you follow. And then why so many people have followed Rajnish? There's so many people who like what Rajnish does, what Rajnish says. As long as he says things which are liked by so many people will get attracted to them. In this world, in the same way, if a brand keeps saying what people like, and it will get attracted by those people. And there's enough number of us who want to feel, at least in our mind, as mature as Akshay, to do those things, and then wanting to be like a man, because you can't be like a man at workplace. You can't be like a man in at home. The relationships have changed. You know, you can't bash up your girlfriend's advice or your colleagues. You can't do many things which earlier men used to get satisfaction from. Then what do you do? Somewhere in your mind you need to think that, okay, I can run. So buy new Nike and buy iPod and run. Or I can do some other stuff. So people need simple gratifications to vent out what they actually feel inside. And then if you do that in a contemporary way, and then the brand will always remain contemporary, and you will always find a place in people's lives. This is the just second brand. This is again, I was talking about, you know, what is the category truth when they were launching HDFC. Category truth is nobody wants to invest money into future. Because future, nobody knows what will happen. What is the point? It's like a beautiful coffin. So what do you do when you are alive, you can't use it. When you are dead, you don't even know where you are. So insurance is like that. What are you going to do when you get money after you are dead? And first, nobody thinks that they will die. Second, nobody thinks that when he dies, his family will suffer. Okay. God will take care of everything. So what do you actually, how do you actually tell people that that you are going to die? Or even if you are not going to die, if you don't have one liver, one eye, maybe 20 of your teeth gone, maybe something else, you become a diabetic patient or you become something else, then what do you do? How are you going to take care of your needs? If you tell brutal reality to people, they won't accept you. Then you will become like LIC. Then you have to show a man with a garland. And people don't like that. And how do you make an interpretation and then make people realize that they need to have some savings for the future? Without talking about death, if they are going to be alive, how are they going to live? If you tell people that, do you want to borrow money when you are 60? From your brother-in-law, from your daughter? You can't say son and daughter. Son is okay to take. And brother is okay to take. Brother-in-law you can't take. So suddenly people will sit up and say that, you know, how dare you say things like that? Oh, my dead body, I will never ask my brother-in-law. So the moment you tell people that you lose your self-respect if you ask money, financial independence at every stage of life is the most important thing for every civilized being. You know, how many deaths a teenager died when he actually have to go and then ask his father, daddy, give me money or the pay fees. Given a choice, he wanted to pay his own fee. He wanted to do his own work, not an engineering which his father wants him to do. Everybody wants, at whatever stage of life, people want financial independence. That is human truth. And then the product truth is it gives you financial independence. Correct? Category truth is that when you actually put both of them and then have very powerful human emotion called self-respect, and then you have got a brand identity.
was the very first commercial to actually establish self-respect, you know, how it gets passed on two generations. And what we did is, after that, started taking into life and also in two different products. So therefore the task was to create a brand which is very honest, which has lots of integrity, and it gives, it's very professional and it gives the right advice to you. To do that, you know, what kind of, if it were to be a human being, what kind of human being that person would be? Almost like a life partner, will always be selfless and then give you the right advice. Everybody keeps saying that you are a great man, great man, great man. But only a life partner tells you that, you know, don't get carried away by all the stupidities. Be firm on your ground and don't get hurt off. Correct? So it takes somebody without any kind of agenda to actually tell you the truth and then give you the right answer. And Tata's are the kind of company which actually thinks in long term, not in short term. They're extremely transparent, they're not selfish, they don't want to make a big buck today and then give you a wrong advice when certain stocks are not doing well. And then say they don't buy infra bonds, you buy something else. Because they're that kind of people. And the brand personality was from the way they behave. So therefore we said that Tata Capital would be a partner with conscience. Two normal people, they are seeking a partner with conscience. I want to have long-term investment plans. I don't know where to invest. I want somebody to advise. I don't want to change my advisor every third day. I'm looking for somebody who partner me for some time. So if that is the idea, which is coming out of both product truth and then life truth, then we say one simple thing which Tata Capital can promise to the world, that we will only do what is right for you. Hum kare wahi jo aapke liye hai. It is not just an empty promise which you do in advertising. The entire Tata Motors, Tata Capital is geared up. They have an internal chatter. Their entire training is going to be on that. You know, what is that they can advise time to time to people that what is right for them, not right for the company. So it is both the internal part of the company which is getting rebranded completely and people are going to be trained in that, and then the external part of the world. And this is beginning of creating a brand. Correct? To be honest, to be trustworthy, you have to be transparent and to be caring and to be genuine. These are the kind of values which you will not get. And if you wait to leverage that, then you will have a brand. And you can't do that for some 20th century finance or something. You can actually only do it for Tata, nobody else in this country. You want to see some more examples or skip?
Yes.
You guys have seen Nike tag? Okay, anybody, any of you know what Nike stands for? That's a line, that's not what it stands for.
Winning.
Winning. And what is? Number one.
Higher skill.
No, you were right at early 80s. And early 90s, Nike is all about win at any cost. Struggle, struggle, struggle and win. That attitude has changed. You don't struggle, struggle and win. You want to win effortlessly. It does not matter whether you win or lose. What if this give life and death and then you run, give away your blood and then win? Who wants? So attitude has changed across the world. And it does not matter winning or losing, participation and enjoyment is much more. And more normal people, you know, who actually buys a 8,000 rupee shoe? The guy who runs and wins? Can you buy, any of you buy 8,000 rupee shoe? I buy Lacoste, 15,000 bucks. I have money. Correct? I can't run, but in my head, I want to feel like a runner. I stand on my treadmill, do 15 minutes, I get off. But I want to feel. It is the inside of Nike today. It is making every amateur feel like an athlete. It is bringing out athleticism from you. That's what Nike is doing. And all these commercials which you see, which are all last 5 years commercials, are moving towards them. It is a part of winning in soccer and stuff like that, but even that is also told from normal people's perspective. The very last commercial in this series, which is the latest one, last year's one, which will reflect that. But enjoy this commercial. Newly wedded wife of his had actually made him famous because this won a Grand Prix at came that year, and he became a world famous creative person. So it is simple insights, you know, which actually make people like us, you know, make millions, and therefore choose like this.
Thank you.
Konkani song, is the Konkani song.
Today, world over creative people have got only one challenge. I have no money,
Can you give me 1,000 rupees? How is it possible? You have to be innovative. And each time you have to come up with not an advertising idea, but you have to come up with a media idea. You have to come up with a with an idea which actually multiplies the money. Okay. That is the era in which we are living. Today clients say that I have no money. Make me popular. So the entire game has changed. There's too much of pressure on people to deliver without having any resources. That made entire industry, at least worldwide, I've been part of Leo Burnett in finding a solution to this since last year and a half. Then we came up with this proposition of humankind. Brands have to be like human beings. They must understand human beings, and then therefore they must behave like human beings. And then we say, you know, only if brands were to find a human purpose for their existence. That all of us, you know, Mahatma Gandhi has a purpose in life. Lots of millions of people bought into that purpose because their purpose was the same. And then therefore they bought into him. And therefore the entire mission became successful and he became successful. If we know what is the mission of Nike, we all know the mission of Nike. If they have a purpose very well defined, then it is much easier. If my purpose is to be an ambassador for Girl Child, which I am, and then you see in every ad which I do, I bring in two little girls, so that people will like little girls and they want to have little girls. Otherwise today, it's very difficult to have two girls, two sisters. If the first one has very little chance of surviving, God help the second one. If first one were to be a girl, the second child, second girl child, has very big chances of surviving. That means 20 years from now, you will not see sisters. Correct. And if you know very clearly that my purpose is, yeah, I want to do this. I don't care whether Tata guys recognize it or not. I put it because I am very clear what my purpose is. And because all my clients are very clear that what is Pops's purpose, they also buy into it. How can anybody say that I don't want to do good things? I want to show a stereotypical one boy and girl by showing that you are influencing people to kill the second girl child to have one ideal boy and girl. So therefore, like human beings, we find purpose. Brands also need to find purpose. And brands find purpose, human beings find purpose. What do we do? Mahatma Gandhi, what did he do? He did not produce television commercials. Did he? Had he done print campaigns? Shining India. Nothing. So what did he do? The entire inspiration came from that, and that is what it is. We behave. When we know what our purpose is, we behave in certain way. We are kind to people, we are nice to people, and each opportunity we get, we write an article, we tell five other friends. Correct? So human beings behave if they know the purpose in certain way. And that behavior is picked up by society, by friends, by families, by colleagues, by everyone. And then say that, yeah, this guy is like this. Because he behaves that way. He does not carry an advertising board. So therefore, if you were to put that hypothesis for brands, if a brand believes certain things, then brand must behave. It should not put an advertising board saying that I'm an honest man. My brand is very honest. Then the brand must behave. So therefore, what does Tata do? It must do a series of acts, not ads. It must put up a series of acts to make people understand what they are about. Correct? I can't go and then say that I'm the most creative guy in the country, can I? Will anybody believe? I must act. I must do things which will make people say that, Fox is great. That's just a basic human thing we all do, correct? Brands must also behave certain ways. We must put up acts which will make the consumers and people behave, believe that this brand stands for that. And they are trying to tell me this, or they stand for this kind of purpose. I'll show you some work. You know, what you see here, none of them are television commercials. None of them ever ran on mass media. They all different ads. Please, we all know HBO. Everybody knows what HBO is? Okay, what is their positioning, specialization? Movies, everybody, star movies also? They pride themselves as an expert storyteller. They understand stories better than anybody else. Therefore, they bring in the best stories to the audiences. Whether they are feature films, whether they are television series, telefilms, or whether they are the films produced by HBO. They pride themselves that positioning across the world is their expert storytellers. They understand stories better than anybody else. Here is what they did to make people believe that they are experts in stories.
Ancient world was a piece of communication that said, "We're the greatest storytellers in the world are going to tell those stories not just on TV, but in a wide variety of mediums." So instead of creating a piece that just said those things, we created a media program that demonstrated those things. The program launched with street teams passing out curious invitations to a week-long summer evening New York event. These invitations directed people to the city's Lower East Side, where a short film was projected onto the side of a building. Using two high-def projectors, the film created the illusion that the side of the building had been removed, giving you a view into eight different apartments. By the way, viewers could also hold up their invitations and discover clues to the links between the different stories. Stories about life, death, birth, redemption. For audiences outside New York, we created a promo for the project that aired on TV and in theaters. Here's an excerpt. HBOlawyer.com. Here we showcase the same film that was projected onto the wall of the event. Using flashlight technology, viewers could zoom in and follow each piece of storytelling. We got the coolest musicians to compose original tracks that, no matter which one you chose, would fit the exact choreography of the story you were watching. Further exploration on the site revealed a vast cityscape populated with even more stories. Spy a assassin murdering an unlucky FBI agent who staked out his apartment. Viewers are invited to go on demand and see the original film, The Watcher. You see the film literally through the eyes of the lawyer who witnessed this murder. He is discovered by the killer and the watcher turns desperate and panic as he tries to escape. Ancillary websites, mobile content, and blogs make the experience even richer. Culturally, the campaign struck a chord. New York Magazine lauded the project as brilliant highbrow in their approval majors. HBO fans shared their passion for the project in blogs and online forums. Over a million viewers sought out HBOLawyer.com within the first 3 weeks of its launch. And half of HBO's on-demand visitors watched HBO Voyeur within the first week of its release. HBO Voyeur, an immersive campaign that demonstrates HBO's unequal level of storytelling craft well outside of the usual platforms.
a chance to an outsider like Deadline Koreans to generate publicity, to generate interest, which is 100 times more than FedEx can ever do. And by what? Purely money. Nothing. What they did is some stamps on every courier. And what they did was one small. You don't need, even need kasa for that. Correct? One little homemade detonator onto a billboard. What they took is unknown place, one small billboard. Entire world was talking and watching. It was broadcasted on every website. And people were watching. And then how do you get all that? And how is it possible that you spend a couple of $1,000 and then you make entire world stand up and look at you? You have time for a little more?
Yes.
You guys have seen Sony Bravia?
Yes.
Okay? Now see the internet teleport.
Thank you.
We did a simple thing. It costed us less than 200 rupees to actually get the equipment. And we had spent another 10,000 rupees at each center as hire charges. We did a simple thing we all do as children. We had put a bulb here. Okay. And we made the children stand here. The shadow is cast on the wall. Correct? As you move away from the light, what will happen? That's what we did. And we just left it. You know, children were having a ball, not children, even adults. They wanted to look like raptors. That's it. It's a simple solution which made people interact and suddenly sales at Big Bazaar started going up because the interactivity has increased, children did not resist, it became top of mind for mother to actually do that. So that is the technology and that is what the connectivity and interactivity, advertising communication is not one way. You get it back. In a way, today, who owns the brands? Not the manufacturers. You know, all you guys are internet savvy, Facebook savvy, YouTube savvy. Go and then type Nike India. The second video which you get is not a Nike video. The second video when you actually hit, you will see Mammootty. You know who Mammootty is? The Shah Rukh Khan of Bollywood. And then you see Shah Rukh Khan in there. Both of them. It is consumer created video. So who owns the brand? Who gave them the right to distort and then do whatever they want to do? Did they ask Mammootty? Did they ask Nike? They express. And same thing you go to Pulsar. Type Pulsar on YouTube. And what you see is not the Pulsar Mania commercial. You see a series of stunts, hundreds of videos, where people have done stunts with Pulsar. So who owns the brand? It is not manufacturers, it is people. Who owns Mahatma Gandhi? It's not India, it's people. It's not government of India, no? Who owns Amitabh Bachchan? It's not even Amitabh Bachchan himself, people. So we are in a complete people secret world. Even if you wait to have Indian Idol, Royal Guard will come back. Who will come back? There are judges who are sitting there. They have no authority. People have to choose. People are calling back and saying that I want this boy back. Correct? So that is the new life. And then brands are trying very hard. We are trying very hard to actually put Whisper onto Facebook and then talk to teenage girls. There are lots of things which you can talk in mass media about the problems with little girls. And how do you actually talk to them? How do you interact? How do you make your brand part of them? You have a purpose and they have a need. Their purpose, your purpose is the same. It's to be free. So where do you find the opportunity to actually meet them? Facebook. On Facebook, the Burger King. Have you guys seen the Whopper freak out? What they did is Whopper is Burger King's biggest burger. And they said that it is not available in the stores. People go and then ask for Whopper. They said no, it's discontinued. And people got mad. They actually started throwing stones on the stores. It created such a huge publicity for the brand. And after half an hour, they will come back and then say that, no, okay, this is a gag. Here is a Whopper free. And see the number of videos which are there on internet. What they did on Facebook this year is they called it as Whopper sacrifice. And what do you sacrifice? You have to sacrifice 9 friends from Facebook. If you put 9 friends on Facebook, they vanish. They vanish out of your list. They can never come back. And who want to actually sacrifice 9 friends for a Whopper? They did, people did, and Facebook finally had to ban it. It's not real. On Facebook, what you see is only on YouTube, the videos. Because people went berserk. Unwanted guys, old guys like me, they removed. Made a Whopper free. Okay. That is where the new world is. That is where the new branding. Branding is not about the size of brand name, which you see It is the space which you occupy in your mind and then the heart of it. And brands are no different. They are like friends, they are like teachers, they are like children, and they are like spouses, they are like relatives. They have a special place in people's life. And then only if brands and people realize, and the people who are actually dealing with the brands, now tomorrow all you guys, 2 years from now, will deal with brands. They are not some abstract things. Here they have much more things than any human being has. Each brand is like a celebrity. Everybody wants a piece of it. Who does not want a piece of Ferrari? They sell shoes people buy, they sell socks people buy, they sell wallets people buy, they sell ties people buy. What Ferrari has to do with ties? Correct? It is almost like, you know, buying Brad Pitt tie. So they are like celebrities. If we were to manage and then be relevant, we can make very successful things. Any questions? I've taken more time than you. Okay, over to you.
I'd like to thank you so much, and it was a great pleasure having you here.